Bahubali, which is a regional film, which we understand is a regional film that's breaking barriers and crossing boundaries from their region, and that's become such a huge success. Everyone, I can't believe this is finally happening.
Yes.
I remember as a little girl growing up, my mother would use L'Oreal products, and I think it's every little girl's dream to sort of, you aspire, and I think the brand has stood for so much more than just beauty and glamour. I think over the years, and of course, strong women and empowerment is a conversation today, but I think L'Oreal has always stood for that for years. And I know for a fact that somewhere deep down inside, it's had a huge influence on me as a young girl growing up. So thank you so much for that. I don't say this very often, but I do consider this a huge achievement in all of the work that I've done. To be able to represent a brand that really stands for so much, that empowers women, and that also has such amazingly strong individual and talented women that also represent the brand, not just in India, but globally. So thank you so much for including me in your family. And I'm very, very proud and very, very excited, not just of the association, but also the work that L'Oreal has done over the years.
Thank you, Deepika.
Thank you. And of course, coming to today's event, we're here to launch the new collection that's called the Cannes Collection 2017. That's by L'Oreal Paris. And I'd like to reveal the looks and also the cosmetics and the makeup that we've used to actually create these looks. The looks are inspired by Cannes, a place that's bright and sunny, and that's always radiating positivity, that's fun, and I think the collection really truly represents that in every way possible, and also just colors that I feel are me, you know. And I was doing a couple of interviews, and they said, you tend to always wear like bright lip colors, and I feel like today's collection that we're launching is that. I enjoy wearing bright lip colors, reds and oranges, burgundies, and today's collection is all about that. So let's see that.
Deepika ji, jaisa ki hum sab jante hain ki Aishwarya ji Cannes Queen kehlati hain, to kya aapki unse mulaqat hogi, kuch tips lena chahengi unse?
I think, like they just said, I think the dates are there for everyone. Everyone knows on what day I'm walking and what day she is. But yes, of course, if our paths ever cross, I think she's someone who's represented the brand beautifully over the years. Not just the brand, but also she's represented India so beautifully. And, you know, I've always admired the way she's conducted herself. And you know, so of course, if I end up seeing her there, she's someone I know otherwise as well, but if I end up seeing her there, yes, of course.
Firstly, let me tell you, you look stunning. So which designer are you planning to wear at Cannes? Have you started planning already? Is something in your mind?
Well, yeah, we have started planning, but I think I think there's too much focus on clothes. You know, I think the focus should really be about having fun. I think as another woman, we enjoy dressing up, right. We enjoy getting ready. We all also know that being at public events in the way that we do is also in its own very, very stressful. And so I think the focus really is to just have fun. The clothes are exciting, but I think there's so much more to an event than just the clothes itself. But yes, it is something that I'm sure my team is working on, and it'll be fun.
But I know.
मेरा दीपिका जी से प्रश्न ये है कि ब्यूटी प्रोडक्ट्स इतने सारे हैं और मेकअप के भी इतने सारे हैं, ब्यूटी में ये प्रोडक्ट्स कितने इन्हांस करती है किसी ब्यूटी को, और क्यों ज़रूरी है ब्यूटी प्रोडक्ट्स का यूज़ करना?
आई थिंक जैसे आपने कहा, आई थिंक एनहेंसिंग इज द राइट वर्ड, आई थिंक दैट्स द की. ब्यूटी इज नॉट मेकअप, बट योर पर्सनैलिटी इज. What you radiate, what you feel, what you embrace about yourself, how confident you are about yourself, that is beauty. Whether you choose to enhance that or not, that's a choice. So if you choose to use beauty products, or you choose for yourself to enhance certain features, that's when cosmetics come in. And sort of enhance what you already have. For me, that's what cosmetics are. You know, you have to sort of know who you are. You have to sort of know your flaws and your strengths and your weaknesses, and embrace yourself for that and love yourself for that. That's the general philosophy of it. There's the other philosophy of it, which is beauty is also about what you eat. It's how much you sleep. It's what you eat. That's beauty also. And then there's the third aspect of it, which is your skincare and your cosmetics and your hair. So it's all of these things put together.
सवाल ये है कि how do you finalize your look for international red carpet? क्योंकि आपको भी पता है बहुत ज़्यादा pressure होता है. हाल ही में आपने Met का red carpet जो walk किया था, उसमें प्रियंका की dress काफी शायद audience को पसंद नहीं आई थी, and you know what happened. So how do you finalize on your look? Pressure होता है, किस तरह से deal करते हैं इस pressure से?
You're assuming I know what happened. I have no idea what has happened.
Okay, so let me tell you, unke dress par kafi sare tweets hue, bahut sare jokes banaye gaye, unka jo gown tha, jo jacket gown tha, us par. To us cheez ko kis tarah se lete ho aap, aur is pressure se kis tarah se deal karte ho?
You know, I think I've always looked at everything as an opportunity, and what you make of those opportunities. For me, or for her, I'm sure, the opportunity is not about what we're wearing, but it's really about the opportunity and the privilege of being at an event like that. And that's what my focus was. My focus was to feel good in what I wear. Some people might like what I wear, some people might not like what I wear. But I think the intention is always to have fun, whether it's with what you're wearing, or the event that you're going to, or the people that you're going to meet. Because those are the memories that last forever. And I think the only time, well, I can't speak for her, but the only time that I would truly be concerned about what I wear is if my mother gave me flack for something that I wore, or if my girlfriends gave me flack for something that I wore. I think that's the only time I would probably allow any sort of comment to even enter my life.
Also, I feel the fact that you're representing India on such global platforms, that itself is a big thing, Deepika.
Thank you for recognizing that.
Thank you so much. Really. And everyone recognizes that as well.
Hi, Deepika. I'm such a great fan, first of all.
Thank you.
And you look so amazing. Just, you mentioned that beauty is not makeup. So I wanted to ask, what makes you look so glowy, so healthy, so fresh all the time? What is it?
It's that. Oh, where did it go? It's behind that.
Other than L'Oreal Paris, what is it? Something naturally that you do? Like you just enter and there's this aroma around you. It makes you look so fresh. What is it?
So have you got your notebook down? She's going to give all the points, huh?
Wait, did you say aroma or aura? I'm confused.
Both. The everything.
Wow.
It's just...
Oh. I have an aroma.
Yeah.
And aura.
And the aura. And the aura.
The aroma is...
Okay, let's come to aura.
Thank you. That's a big word. I don't know. I think it's taken me a long time to get here. I think it takes immense mental peace to be in this space. and that takes a lot of work. And I think it takes staying focused on the larger picture. That's what it is, I think.
And I also think it's your humility towards people and the warmth and affection you give. So you can add to that.
What have you had for breakfast today?
South Indian food, yeah. Of course. All right, next question, please. Hi, can we move the mic there, please? Hi.
Hi, Deepika. Since you mentioned the bloggers, I'm a blogger myself. This is Shayanti. And I wanted to know, you know, do you believe in being a trendsetter or do you still want to keep to your signature style, things that you love wearing, as far as colors are concerned?
You've known me long enough. What do you think?
I think you're lovely. I mean, everybody follows what you do, but what do you do with, how do you keep to, you know, what you want to do and also balance it out with the trends?
I think all of us have a signature, like we keep saying, there's a signature style or there's an inherent style or there's a signature look that one has or something that we're all very comfortable with. For example, maybe you like to just wear your hair down all the time or maybe you like to wear kajal, you know, so it's different for different people. So I have my signature go-to things as well that I like to do, you know, like I like to put my hair up, I like to wear red lips and different things influence that. It's probably, you know, growing up, you know, I'm sure you've had certain influences in your life. And then there's the experts that I'm fortunate enough to work with. I think they are the guys who sort of help me keep up with what is in trend, whether it's my clothes, whether it's my hair, whether it's my makeup. I don't know that. I don't claim to know that. Is it exciting to learn? Yes, of course it is. Whether it's via social media or, you know, what you guys write or, you know, or you read. So I'm always curious to learn, but at the same time, I don't claim to know that I know, and I'm okay being behind the curve. And then that's why I have an amazing team of people that I work with who will help me find that balance.
So if something goes wrong, would you be affected in terms of a color which, you know, you're not convinced wearing? Or, you know, something which people suggested you wear and you weren't comfortable doing that. Will it affect you at all?
No, not at all. Not at all. In fact, we have fun doing what we do. You know, we're all in a room together and we've never really pre-decided anything. We're really just going with the flow and what we're feeling on that day. And somebody has a hair suggestion, somebody has a makeup suggestion, somebody says you have to wear this, someone says... And eventually the look comes together. And like I said, sometimes it might work, sometimes it may not work. The idea is always to have fun. Don't forget that.
Like we are having fun today.
I have to ask you this, like, you know, L'Oreal has taken the world by storm. The other thing in cinema today that has taken India and the world by storm is Bahubali 2. I have to ask you this.
Kahan se kahan?
Right, okay. So you've also done a couple of regional films, but today we can see that regional films has literally taken over India, Bollywood and all of that. What are your thoughts on the fact that it's become the highest grosser of all times?
That the possibilities are
endless
and limitless. That's why I do a triple X and that's why Priyanka does what she does. Because there's no limit to creativity. There's no limit to anything in life, actually. And that's exactly what it is. And, you know, whether it's us as Indians representing India globally or whether it is a Bahubali, which is a regional film, which we understand is a regional film that's breaking barriers and crossing boundaries from their region and that's become such a huge success. That's exactly what it is, that the possibilities are endless.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is the last question. The lady here. There you go.
Over your center.
Hi. Hi, Deepika. My question is to you. You always have a positive attitude towards life. What motivates you to be what you are?
Wow. What motivates me to be positive? Because there is no other way to be. there is no motivation in that sense. I mean, I think the motivation is to have, like I said earlier, the motivation is to have peace of mind, the motivation is to enjoy my work, the motivation is to do great work. My motivation is to let my parents know that I'm in a good space and that I'm happy. And I feel a lot of it comes from the way they've brought me up. That's just the way we are as a family. And that's how I've seen my father and my mother conduct themselves as well. And I guess that's what it is.
Thank you so much to all our friends from the media as well. That was the last question. Thank you, Deepika, and thank you, Rajjeet. And I know you're going to do wonders for us at the Cannes. And I know one thing's for sure, you're going to keep the flag of L'Oréal Paris fly high always. Please give it up for Rajjeet and Deepika Padukone, ladies and gentlemen. You.